friends, welcome to EduTab. So welcome to the Everyday at 5 series for IBPS AFO 2018-19 brought to you by EduTab. Now friends, this particular series is all about discussing small topics taken from the subject of agriculture. So we'll try our maximum to discuss as many topics as possible. So this is lecture number 4. So in lecture 3, what we had done is we had discussed some of the MCQs taken from horticulture crops, specifically mango, which is a fruit crop, right? And in today's lecture, what we'll do is we'll discuss some other information as well when it comes to mango. And simultaneously, we had also asked certain questions in the previous lecture. So let us just discuss the answers for those as well, right? So let us begin with this lecture today. So friends, here you can have a look at some of the very important points, just introductory. You can see that there is a scientific name which is given, right? It's Mangifera indica, right? So just you need to know the scientific names as well. I have been repeating this point again and again because it is quite important. Sometimes in the options, you just get the scientific name and it becomes difficult if you don't know, okay? And it belongs to the family Anacardaceae. Right? And obviously it is known as the king of fruits, mango, loved by everyone, right? And it is actually a tropical fruit, and you also call it as a pride fruit of India. Okay, there's one other important information that you can see here, that ripe fruit, that is ripe mango fruit, contains 16 to 20% of total soluble solid, or TSS, whatever it is called, right? So you need to understand that this TSS value is important. So nearly 20% of it is TSS. We'll see what it is in the coming section, right? And a mango is an excellent source of vitamin A, right? And specifically A as well as B and C. Okay, so this is some information that you need to just keep in mind. Okay, so we were talking about TSS, that is total soluble solid, right? So it refers to basically the soluble solids content of a solution. Okay, so now if you talk about fruits, what is the solution? It is obviously the fruit juice. Okay, so in fruit juice, what is the total soluble solid content is represented by TSS. Okay, now when you talk about the solid, what is this solid? See, mainly the important constituent of solid is sugars. Okay, but there are other ingredients as well, like you have smaller amounts of organic acids, you have vitamins, proteins, free amino acids, essential oils and glucosides as well, right? But mainly it is sugars. Now, when you want to determine this TSS, you usually use index of refraction. Okay, so you're using the medium of light. We will not go into the detail of how this process is done. Okay, that is not in the scope, but you just need to know that the scale which is used to measure this is known as Brick scale. Okay, it gives the percentage of total soluble solids in a substance. Okay, so remember Brick scale. Okay, remember what is TSS, and just have an idea that nearly 20% of mango ripened fruit contains TSS. Okay. Fine. Now coming to next important parameters that we shall discuss. So this was a question also that we had put forth in the previous lecture, that what is the optimum temperature which is required during the growing season? Okay, so it is 24 to 27 degrees Celsius. Kindly make a note of it. Okay, and now mango grows well in tropical as well as subtropical region. Okay, and when referring to, remember, let us just also have a quick, you know, recap. So when we were doing lecture 1 and 2, we were referring to apple horticulture crop, a fruit crop, and there we had seen that apple is a temperate crop. Okay, so you can just simultaneously start revising also, so that you will never get confused between various things. Okay, so annual rainfall, if you see, the average is 250 centimeters. Okay, and coming to soil, all types of soil from alluvial to laterite soils are good for mango cultivation, but except black cotton soil. Okay, because black cotton soil actually has poor drainage. Okay, why is it so? Because black soils, usually the clay content is higher. So obviously the clay particles are smaller. Okay, so it does not allow the water to drain freely when you compare to loamy or the sandy soils. Okay, so these are some of the properties of soil that you need to understand. Only then you will be able to appreciate its features. Okay, now it prefers slightly acidic. well-drained, fairly deep, and loamy soil rich in organic matter. Okay, so here you can take a clue. Just keep in mind that all types of soils are generally preferable, but there is an exception that you do not want or you cannot cultivate it in black cotton soil. The reason being it has poor drainage facility. Okay, now the pH that is required is slightly on the acidic side. Okay, starting from it. So the pH range can be 5.5 to 7.5. Right, and then talking about the growing states. Okay, this was also a question that we were discussing previously. So the growing states being Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Karnataka, Bihar, and Gujarat. Okay, yesterday we also saw a variety specific to Bihar that is called Kishan Bhog. That was one of the questions that we had discussed. Right, and there's also a very famous variety we shall see further in the further sections belonging to each of the states. Right, now propagation method. So when we were having a look at the crop apple, we had seen that the propagation method can be two types: the vegetative propagation method, which is the asexual method. It can be either budding or grafting. Okay, so the most popular methods. So when you come to mango, so the type of grafting that is usually done is veneer grafting. Just keep this in mind. Important, right? And there's other kind as well, that is epicotyl or stone grafting and inarching. So these are some of the names you actually need to remember. Okay. See, it is not possible for us to immediately cover in this lecture all the concepts in a broader way, but still we'll try to catch hold of certain terms which might be difficult for you guys. For example, we were talking about veneer grafting. Right, so let us see what it is, because if we see what it is, you'll be able to remember this well and it is not going to be difficult for you guys. Right, so friends, one thing you need to understand that when you talk about grafting, there are two parts, as this also has been discussed previously. I'm just repeating it again. One is scion, okay, the other is the rootstock. Right, and when you talk about scion is basically the upper portion. Okay, and when you talk about rootstock, it is a lower portion. Okay, so what is done in grafting, the upper portion of one plant and the lower portion of the other plant is combined and allowed to grow as a single plant. Okay, that is what happens in grafting. So now if you see, veneer grafting is shown in the figure. So what you can see, a small wedge is removed from the rootstock. You can see this is a rootstock which contains the root, the lower portion of the plant, right? We were just discussing here. So a small part is cut out. Okay, that is a wedge. It is removed. Okay, now in the small part, the scion is actually placed, and usually this takes place sideways. You can have a look here. Okay, so this, you can see here how neatly they have placed this scion in this wedge that was created in the rootstock. Okay, then after that, what they have done, they have tied this together, and after some time, natural regeneration would take place and this would grow as a single plant. Okay, so this is a kind of a veneer grafting. Sideways it is done, a wedge is created, scion actually beautifully placed inside that wedge. Okay, fine. Coming to other important parameters, let us quickly have a look at it. One is planting season. So planting is done in July and August when you talk about rain fed areas. When you talk about irrigated areas, it is done in February to March. Okay, and harvesting period is March to mid-August. Okay, okay friends, so we'll do one thing. Let's revise one concept here, because we are talking about harvesting. Let me just tell you that we were discussing about something called climacteric and non-climacteric fruit. Right, so we were discussing that there are certain fruits which continue to ripe even after they are plucked from the trees. Okay, and there are certain fruits that stop their ripening process, or they no more ripe once they are plucked. Okay, so this is a difference between climacteric and non-climacteric. Okay, now just let me know whether mango falls in the category of climacteric or non-climacteric. Okay, this is one small homework which you can actually mention it in the comment section below. Right, right? Okay, moving forward, planting method, there are different systems which are followed, but obviously for each crop there can be certain popular methods or systems as well. So when you talk about mango, the most popular being square and rectangular. Okay, now pitch size is 1 into 1 into 1 meters. Okay, and planting space is 10 meter into 10 meter for tall varieties. This is important. Okay, and when you talk about dwarf varieties, it is 7 meter into 7 meter. Okay, so far we have discussed two questions that were actually asked in the previous lecture. One is which are the states which grow mango. We have seen that. We have seen the optimum temperature. In the further section, let us see other questions as well that were asked as part of homework in the last lecture. Now, yield, if you see, it ranges between 10 to 20 kg per tree per year, right? Let us move forward. Okay, now coming to major diseases, this is important, right? And yesterday in the previous lecture, we were discussing about this as well. So this was also one of the questions. So let us quickly see what are the famous or rather prominent diseases. There is internal fruit necrosis, which takes place. This is due to boron deficiency. Okay, there is sap burning. Okay, the sap burning is basically post-harvest disorder. So once the mango has been plucked and undergoing transportation to various centers, then you have mango malformation. Okay, there is black tip. Okay, due to brick kiln fumes. There is spongy tissue. This particular spongy tissue is specific in Alfonso mango, a very popular variety. Right, then you have powdery mildew. Yesterday we saw this as an option as well, and you can see this powdery mildew actually affects a lot of crops. So do not get confused. It is not, there are various species of it, okay, that affect various other crops. So do not get confused out here. Okay, so now since we were talking about powdery mildew, so basically you can see it's a fungal disease, important to note. Okay, and it actually has the capability to destroy the plant completely. Okay, and it, because it is a category of fungi, it actually requires certain high humidity and cloudy weather. So this is a perfect combination for fungal growth to take place. See, what happens is usually gray white powdery blocks are seen on the fruitlets. Okay, so it is like powder, and that's why the name also powdery mildew. Okay, now what is important is the control measures that can be taken. Okay, so have an idea regarding it. You can apply sulfur, carathane, bevacizin, or benlate. Okay, so these are some of the names you should be aware of. So at least pause the videos, have a look at these names, okay, and have a look at the percentage as well. Okay, now coming to pest, this was also something that we were discussing. We discussed about mango hopper. This was there as part of the question, right? Now, the other pests are also there. One is nut weevil. This is important, stem borer and fruit fly. So have an idea regarding these. Okay, so varieties based on time of ripening, okay, early season, mid season and late. Now what you need to do is you need to be aware of the names of these varieties, because sometimes you might get a very simple question like, out of the given options, which is not a variety of mango or which is a variety of mango. So if you get certain kind of questions, obviously how can you answer that? You can answer only if you're aware of the various varieties. Okay, so that is why you do not need to just memorize everything, but once or twice if you go through these names, you will be able to eliminate or pick from the options that you see in the paper. Okay, so if you see early, it is Bombay green, Himsagar, Kesar, Subarnarekha, right? Mid season you have Alfonso, again a very important variety, Mankorod, Bangalore, Vanraj, Banganapalli. This is again very important. Okay, the Sheri is famous, Langra, Kishanbhog, Bihar variety, right? Then you have Zardalu, you have Fuzli, Fernandin, Mulgao, Neelam and Chausa. Neelam and Chausa, again very famous, used in crossing, right? So again, have a it might sound very hectic that, you know, in one go, how do we memorize all these things, you know, but we have to do it. So how can we do it? By revising it again and again. Okay, Fine. Now, this is an important tabular column. You need to be aware of it. These are certain hybrid varieties that you can see on your screen. Okay, and they have also given the place of research. Okay, so again, you might get an option. So now, these things you need to be aware of. So if you know, this was a question that we have discussed yesterday regarding the hybrid variety Mallika. So what is the cross that is done? Neelam into Dasheri. Right, so this was something that we were discussing, that when we say Neelam into Dasheri and Dasheri into Neelam, is it different? Okay, yes, it is different. So even if you think that both the parent that are involved are same, so why is it going to yield to different varieties? Let me tell you the reason. See, out of these two, one represents female parent, okay, and one represents male parent. Okay, so usually the one that is mentioned in the first place denotes female. Okay, and the one that is denoted in the second, that is after the cross, is actually representing the male parent. So obviously, when you switch female and male parent, now in this cross, if you see, the Dasheri would actually become the female parent, right? And your Neelam would become the male parent. So obviously the characteristics are going to vary. That is why the cross that is resulting is going to be different. Okay, so always have that thing in mind. Now if you see Amrapali, again it is the Dasheri into Neelam. So we have got the answer for the question that we have given yesterday, right? There is a variety of Ratna, Neelam into Alfonso, Sindhu, Ratna into Alfonso. So again, you're using one hybrid variety. With that hybrid variety, you are crossing a variety. Okay. Then you have Arka Puneet. Okay. Alfonso into Banganapalli. Again, you need to memorize these cross. It might sound hectic, but we have to do it. Okay, now these are some of the new varieties that have been released by Indian Agricultural Research Institute. Okay, so it is Pusa Surya, Pusa Arumina. Okay, now this Pusa Arumina is actually a cross between Amrapali and Sensation, which is a US variety. Okay, you have Akshay, you have Sasogartha. I'm really sorry if I'm pronouncing it in a different way. It's a cross between Totapuri and Kesar. Again, very important varieties and famous ones. In the mango seasons, people are actually behind these mango varieties. It is very famous among the crowd. Okay, again, let us see some of the important points. Now, when you talk about Alfonso, most popular variety of India, everyone knows the name of it. Now, Banganapalli is a very important commercial variety of Andhra Pradesh. Note this down, okay? Bombay Green, it is the earliest variety of North India. It is called Malda in UP and Sehroli in Delhi. This is important, friends. Okay, so you need to know that Malda is a variety of UP and Sehroli of Delhi, okay? Chausa, it is the sweetest variety of mango, okay? Again, we were seeing about this Chausa as well. There's the Dasheri, popular variety of Northern India. This Fuzli, which is late maturing variety. Kesar, again, good processing variety. You have Langra, okay? You have Niranjan, you have Neelam, best combiner variety. That is why it is most frequently used in crosses. Okay, you have Rosica, mutant variety of mango. Lal Sindhuri. Okay, this is important because it is powdery mildew resistant. We have seen that this particular disease is very dangerous. It can actually lead to the entire crop failure. So this particular variety, we can say it is resistant variety of powdery mildew. And other varieties can be Gulab Khas, Totapuri, and all these things we have just seen, right? So now coming to the last section about storage. Okay, so obviously it requires a certain conditions that are favorable for the crop to stand. Okay, the fruits to stand, in fact, sorry. So the harvested fruits are pre-cooled to 10 to 12 degrees Celsius. Okay, and now you can see these are the storage temperatures that are given for different varieties. At least have an idea of the relative humidity, that is 85 to 90%. Now, as per Planning Commission's 11th plant report, these are some of the data points that you need to know, like the temperature condition should be favorable of 13 degrees Celsius for storage, relative humidity again 85% to 90%, storage period nearly 2 to 3 weeks, okay, it ripens fast, freezing point is 1 degree Celsius, okay, so these are some of the general parameters. So friends, with this we have come to the end of this particular lecture today. So it is a bit a longer lecture when you compare it to yesterday's, because we were having various other explanations included as well. So now if you have any query, you can actually go to our website www.edutab.co.in. You can also drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can give us a call at 814-620-7241. So quickly having a look at the courses offered by EduTab for IBPS AFO 2018-19. So we have a full video course which includes a test series as well. And you will be getting videos, content sheet, summary sheet, worksheet and MCQs for each of the topics in agriculture. And this can be bought for a price of ₹2499, which is valid or available for the first 100 subscribers of us. And then you have a separate test series as well, which can be availed at a price of ₹1499. So it includes 25 full-length tests as well as 25 sectional tests. So friends, with this we have come to the end of this lecture, and if you found this video useful, so kindly like, subscribe and share. And the PDF format of this particular video can be accessed from EduTab's Telegram channel. The link for the channel is placed on your screens, as well as you can find the link in the description box of this particular video. Till then friends, thank you so much. Happy learning.